Hello everyone. First of all, thank you very much for all your encouragement and support. I'm humbled. I'm very grateful to each and every one of you who visited the site, looked at the video, sent your appreciation. I'm also very thankful to those of you who gave your feedback. One of you even pointed out an important error in my last video. That's the reason why I'm repeating a part of it. So a couple of you felt that the leads was a bit rushed, so it was difficult to understand. So I'll try to simplify it a little more for you. So here we go. Starting off with the ECG leads. So to make matters simple, now remember I told you that your ECG machine is like a glorified galvanometer. So if that's the galvanometer, you have a positive pole and you have a negative pole. Now these positive and negative poles are connected to the galvanometer by means of something known as a lead. So when you come to your ECG, you have two types of leads. You have bipolar leads and you have unipolar leads. Bipolar leads are your limb leads. That is lead 1, lead 2, lead 3. Unipolar leads are either limb leads or chest leads. Now by convention, unipolar leads are designated by the letter V. So unipolar chest leads are V1 to V6 and unipolar limb leads are AVR, AVL, AVF, right arm, left arm, left leg respectively. The right leg is a neutral electrode. Okay. Now coming to the bipolar leads. With the heart at the center, if you have a equilateral triangle connecting the right arm, the left arm and the left leg, the lead with its positive pole at the left arm and negative electrode at the right arm is lead 1. The lead with its positive electrode at the left leg and negative electrode at the right arm is lead 2. And this is where I had made a mistake in the last video. The lead with the positive electrode at the left leg and the negative electrode at the left arm is lead 3. So the left leg has got positive electrodes of 2 and 3. The left arm has got one positive and one negative, whereas the right arm has got both negative electrodes. Now the unipolar lead at the right arm is AVR. And as you can see, AVR is always negative. Now the reason AVR is always negative is, if you remember the basic concept of, if this is an electrode, current coming towards an electrode gives a positive deflection and current going away from an electrode gives a negative deflection. So the AVR, which is looking at the heart from the right side, the predominant current, the vector of current, is going away from AVR. That's why AVR is always negative. P is negative, QRS is negative, P is negative in AVR. So this triangle with the heart in the center and three bipolar leads, that is lead 1, lead 2 and lead 3 on either side, is known as Einthoven's triangle. Now you also have a law known as Einthoven's law. And it's simple for you to remember that Einthoven's law states that lead 2 is equal to lead 1 plus lead 3. This is in vectorial form. There is a formula to derive this. I don't want to get into it because if I do, then you will get confused. Remember, when you are calculating lead 1 or lead 3 or lead 2 by amplitude, you have to calculate it in a vectorial form. By vectorial form, I mean if this is the baseline and you have your ECG like that, you count the amplitude above in millimeters. So say this is plus 5 and the negative one again, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 4. So the net vector will be 5 minus 4, that is plus 1. Alright. On the other hand, if it is like that, where you have minus 2 above and plus 4 below, then the net vector becomes minus 2 plus 4, that is minus 2. Okay, so this is how you have to calculate the vectors when you come to an ECG. More about it when we talk about axis. So now coming to unipolar leads. When I say unipolar leads, what do I mean? I mean that the positive pole is connected to the body of the patient and the negative pole is formed by either a Wilson's central terminus or Goldberger's central terminus. So what do you mean by Wilson's central terminus? Wilson's central terminus is nothing but an average of the left arm electrode, the right arm electrode and the left foot electrode. So when you take an average of all the three, what you get is the Wilson's central terminal. But the problem with putting the Wilson's central terminal and connecting all three electrodes to the opposite side of the galvanometer was that the amplitude or the voltage of the QRS was very, very small. So what Goldberger did essentially was he made a modification in which, for example, if you are seeing the electrode with a unipolar lead VR at the right arm, conventionally the negative pole had to have VR, VL and VF connected. That was your galvanometer. What Goldberger simply did was, when VR is at the positive pole, he excluded it from the negative pole. By removing the electrode which you are measuring on the positive pole from the negative terminus, he was able to amplify the amplitude of the QRS exponentially. And hence, this became an augmented lead, because you are amplifying the voltage or augmenting the voltage. So that VR became AVR, VL became AVL and VF became AVF. So that is how you got augmented ventricle, right side, augmented left side and augmented foot. So this is in brief about your unipolar limb leads. Now, in addition to this, you also have unipolar chest leads V1 to V6 and then you have V7, V8 and V9 which are posterior leads as well. The location and other things you will get it in textbook, so I don't want to repeat it too much. But this is in brief about your leads. Thank you.